Well, hello, so where I should start? It's been a while since I did a personal vlog, but anyways, this is a informative vlog about the recent events. Currently, I'm coding as fast as I can, but I'm bouncing against limits of Minecraft, which I try to avoid to get the best experience and bug-free, of course. Well, the problem currently is that I was under attack by some user on my Discord, but also on Spigot private messaging system, about him claiming something that has already expired. To make something more clear to everyone, I'm not the one that he says I am. I'm not a scammer, I'm not a hater, and I always do what I promise. The only problem is that he is very, very mad at me for basically misunderstood what I wrote back then. The last plugin, MCG Space, was announced 2 weeks before I started the last 2 weeks of access to my plugin. So basically 4 weeks before the end of the MCG Space plugin, I put an announcement in an update notification of that plugin. It stated that in 2 weeks, well, 2 weeks before the end, I will start a special conversion day. Basically conversion weeks, because I let it go for 14 days. In those 14 days back then, people could exchange their Space plugin for the new one by emailing to a special made address for that event. This user that currently complained in this network, he contacted me because he heard from a friend that he could claim the new one for free because he has the old one, etc., etc. The weird thing is, the old one is already deleted because it's like 4 weeks ago by now that the event ended for the free conversion. And why it ended is because I cannot check anything. My PayPal account that I used back then was broken. The end result is that people would not get their product in time and I had to manually add everyone after they paid. It's currently fixed because I have a new PayPal account that uses it. However, the old one is gone, so I cannot check any payments anymore from the old account, from the old plugin, and the plugin is also deleted, so I cannot check the buyers list the same way. This user, I explained it to him and offered him as another chance, basically. If he can prove that I promised him what he claims that I promised. He says that I spoke to him in person, stating that he must buy the old one and gets the new one for free. I never said that. That's something worth noticing. And even if I said it, then I always give a special email address with it, so he can send the email to it containing the same request. Why I ask always that and using that mail system is that I have proof to cover myself if somebody becomes angry at something and claims that he purchased something that he got free, you know? So, to be short, if anyone is any time mad at me for not giving a plugin for free, let me be short. I work many times a day on coding the plugin, but also managing my network, also keep everything up. All the websites are running, the servers are running, and it costs me about 30 euros a month, some close to it. And currently, people are blaming me for not providing years of work for free. If people are complaining, go search some other plugin. I'm very simple at it. If you do not want to pay, do not do it. Go to some other developer, ask him if he wants to give it free. My money is very low that I asked for it. There are many plugins that are amazing, to say the least, and they ask 40 euros for the same plugin. It's huge, It has a lot of features. It's unique. That's what you pay for. But in my case, you only pay for the work I put in it. Not for the features. Not for the things. Because I keep adding them, even if the price stays the same. That's the whole point. And I find it sad. And I feel sad about this issue. I do not like the feeling that people call me a scammer or call me somebody who break promises and who is stealing money from people. I'm certainly not doing that. I almost have no money myself. So how in the world should I do that? The things that I get in my life is for the work that I put in it. And I may not work normally. I cannot go outside and find a job. I'm blocked by that in my country. Reason for that is that I have autism. I cannot fulfill a normal job, as they stated. I code for you guys because that's something I can do and have fun with it. And beside that, asking a little bit amount to cover the costs for a small part that I put into it, if that's too much to ask, go find another plugin. And if everyone have the same feeling about this, let me know. I will pull down all my plugins. I mean, why should I code for people who only express hate? Just because it costs like a few euros. No, I do not like the way that works, and I certainly do not like that person. To be clear, if somebody breaks the rules on my Discord, they get banned. I warned him 4 times before I even eventually put a ban on. I even asked my friend, my staff member that keeps an eye out on all my networks, to help me with it, because this person seriously was angry at everything I do, everything I want, everything he wants. He wants everything for free. He says that I stole his money. Well, sorry, but how can I steal somebody's money if that person himself lives in Spain? So that's weird, to say the least. I live in Holland. You may know that. That's because it's a little bit far away from Spain, isn't it? And about scamming, no. I always deliver what people want, and the delivery is out of my hands. As soon as you go to Spigot and you buy a plugin, you will get it directly. I do not interact with that. It's as simple as that. I make a plugin. You can read the reviews before you buy it. You can read all the data before you buy it. If you have questions, you can do that before you buy it. And if you buy it, you get it directly. So I can never scam people because they already have it. And if I want to scam, then I have a certainly big problem, because the networks that I do sell on check the plugins before it's allowed to be sold. So nothing he says is true. And if people do think I make good plugins, please let me know. I love to get positive feedback. And if something is broken, I hear it and I fix it. I do it for everyone. So I will end this video here. It's a short one, but it will certainly make my point clear. I do not like being hated by people just because I make a plugin and ask something for it. And I also make a statement from now on. People claiming like that, I will not even speak to them. I'm not gonna put any energy in people who say that I'm a scammer and hate people and try to steal their money. No. I'm not like that, and I'm not gonna do it, and I'm not ever want to do anything negative against somebody unless they ask for it, like saying that I'm a scammer and I warn them and I still do it again. I remove them from my network. It's my right. So thank you for the time to listen to me, and I hope to see you basically soon and hear from everybody. If you ever want to tell me something, or just want to leave a comment stating how thankful or why you like some things that I make or what you think of my plugins or what I do, let me know. My Discord is open for everyone and every message that's posted, I read them all. I never skip one. So let me know if you think anything positive. And if something is negative and it's constructive criticism, then I'm allowed it too. It's not a problem. I want to fix if something is broken. I thank you all for watching. Till the next time.